Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Mountbatten Festival of Music 2017, coming to you live from the Royal Albert Hall, London. This, the 45th year of the concert, we bring you even more exciting music, spectacular drum displays, and beautiful solos from the very finest military musicians in the United Kingdom. We also have with us, for the very first time, the top secret drum corps, especially from Switzerland, to perform in the show tonight. With the help of you, our audience, we aim to raise as much money as possible for the Royal Marines charity, who do fantastic work helping Royal Marines and their families in times of need. This show is being live streamed across the globe tonight only, and we'd like to thank The Telegraph, the Royal Windsor Horse Show, the Portsmouth Historic Dockyard, and the Royal Yacht Britannia for supporting this live stream. We'd love you to help share this concert to as many people as possible, so please hit that like button, tweet at hashtag MFMLive, and share it to as many people as possible so we can raise some fantastic funds for the Royal Marines charity. Tonight you will be entertained by 120 of the finest military musicians live on the stage behind me, as well as our world-famous Corps of Drums and the fanfare team. We really hope you enjoy the show, and please do help us support the Royal Marines charity, who do fantastic work helping Royal Marines and their families in times of need. To donate, just text BAND 17 £5 to 770 to donate £5. Please note though, this is only for UK viewers. If you're watching overseas, you can still donate by visiting www.theroyalmarinescharity.org.uk/donate. And remember, you can still donate after the show is finished by visiting the website. With His Royal Highness Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, in attendance, ladies and gentlemen, the Mountbatten Festival of Music 2017, featuring the massed bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to the Royal Albert Hall for the 2017 Mountbatten Festival of Music. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A very, very warm welcome to you all from me, Charles Collingwood. Some of you may know me best as Brian Aldridge from BBC Radio 4's The Archers. Yes? Oh, thank you. Yes. Oh. Now, honestly, if you clap that, you'll clap anything. Now, for just over 40 years, I've had to endure being referred to as the JR of Ambridge. However, tonight, as Charles, may I say how delighted I am to be back with you again, having had the privilege of comparing here 2 years ago. I must say a special hello tonight to all those watching online via our groundbreaking live stream. I haven't a clue what that means, but I'm sure it's terribly important. This is the 45th year of these concerts in the Royal Albert Hall, which raise many thousands of pounds for the Royal Marines charity and Click Sergeant Cancer Fund for Children. Performing tonight are the Royal Marines Bands Portsmouth, Scotland, and Commando Training Centre Royal Marines, the mass bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines. This evening's show opened with music from the film Wing Commander, specially arranged by Warrant Officer Bandmaster Ivan Hutchinson, and featured our spectacular 14-piece fanfare team. Making his first appearance at the festival as a conductor, please welcome the Director of Music of the Royal Marines Band Scotland, Captain Matt Waits. So we continue now in traditional style by introducing our world-famous corps of drums with the iconic march On the Quarterdeck, written in 1917 by the former Royal Marines Director of Music, Kenneth J. Alford. The corps of drums will then assemble on stage to another arrangement by Warrant Officer Ivan Hutchinson with Flight of the Silver Bird. This is followed by a new dynamic drum display entitled Pedententim 60, written by buglers Ben Payne and Kyle Porter. Next, Warrant Officer Bandmaster Russ Young has composed a dazzling piece called Deterrence, featuring the massed bands and corps of drums in salute to the Royal Navy's Vanguard-class submarines, which carry the nation's strategic nuclear deterrent. Staying with the submarine service to complete this opening section is a world premiere of a new bugle march, Astute, composed by band colour sergeant Gareth Keechy. So, ladies and gentlemen, with startling dexterity and precision drill, I give you the Corps of Drums of the Royal Marines. Thank you. The Corps of Drums, ladies and gentlemen, they're fantastic, aren't they? Give them another round of applause, please. Absolutely. Quite sensational. They seem to get better and better and better. And what amazes me, as someone who's had to spend his entire life learning lines, is that they do it all from memory. Quite extraordinary. Now, for those of you wishing perhaps, and I've got to phrase this bit a bit carefully, for those of you wishing perhaps to take some buglers home for a display in the comfort of your own home, that's what it says here, DVDs of the 2016 ceremony of beating retreat on Horse Guards Parade are on sale at various locations in the hall tonight. A giant from the Romantic period, Hector Berlioz, is a well-known and well-regarded composer. Our overture tonight was written in 1844 whilst Berlioz was in Nice under the title La Tour de Nice, the Tower of Nice. He later revised and retitled it La Corsaire. A corsair is, of course, another term for a pirate. And with 90% of today's world trade being transported by sea, piracy is a real threat. Fortunately, we have the Royal Navy spearheading the fight against this. Ladies and gentlemen, we have had two sensational evenings of music so far this week. But my next introduction is tinged with sadness, because conducting La Corsaire tonight in what will be his final Mountbatten Festival of Music before retiring at the end of this year is the Principal Director of Music. I want to hear you give the biggest round of applause for the Principal Director of Music, Royal Marines, Lieutenant Colonel Nick Grace, OBE.
Thank you.
Now, one of the really special things about tonight is that I know that in the hall tonight are lots and lots of friends and family of the Royal Marines who've come there, especially this evening, to support them and give them the biggest cheer they possibly can. And we are now coming, yes, you'll have a chance, because next is our now regular section highlighting some of the extremely talented musicians in the band service with our soloists parade. La Khalifa is a haunting melody written by the renowned and prolific film composer Ennio Morricone. This has been tastefully arranged for tonight by Warrant Officer Bandmaster Tom Hodge, and it features the fine solo oboe of Band Colour Sergeant Joe Sharp. That is one person who has a family in tonight. Lots of family. His wife, Karina, his daughter, Beth, who's 26, please don't sing happy birthday, Matt, the son who's in the paras, they've all come up from Devon to support Joe when he plays his solo oboe. So no pressure there, Joe. Following Joe, and to recognise the 100th anniversary since the death of the American ragtime composer Scott Joplin, we feature the ever-popular percussion section with a brand new arrangement of his classic Maple Leaf Rag. Michael McDermott has arranged this for band Corporal Mike Smith and musician Joe Kemp on xylophone. Now, those of you who are familiar with these percussion solos will know that our soloists usually like to inject some humour. And I've no reason to believe that tonight will be any the different. But to begin with, this year's soloist parade, we feature our trombone section with a stylish arrangement from across the pond of Malaguena, originally written for the US Navy Band by Jerry Asconi, himself a former member of the band. This is an exciting piece, especially for our soloists, Colin Hudson, Rachel Botham, Richard Burberry, whose parents are here. Yes, they said they were from Birmingham. Yeah. And last but not least, musician Gwilym Davies. Oh, it's going to be rather raucous, isn't it? I do hope so. Together they give a vivid demonstration of their individual and collective musical prowess. So, under the direction of Colonel Nick, please welcome our quartet of trombones to perform Malaguena.
Thank you. Thank you.
Weren't our soloists fantastic? Let's give them another round of applause, please. Joe Sharp on the oboe did his family proud, eh? And the trombonist, yes. Come on, Joe, stand up. And the trombonist, wow. And then, of course, these two fabulous percussionists. Weren't they amazing? Yeah. Imagine how good they'd be if they got on. Actually, I think, as you might know, Mike Smith is from Cornwall, but yeah, wonderful, welcome. And Joe Kemp has brought all his family here, and most of them are in the front row. Yes, jolly good, yeah. Wasn't he splendid? Yeah, Joe Kemp, absolutely brilliant. And they're all from Northampton. And they thought it was good. They thought it was good. I thought it was a load of old cobblers. Anyway, well done to them all. Now, we are actually now approaching, can you believe it, the end of the first half. And as you enjoy the interval, it's a bit of a hard sell coming now. Please look out for the uniformed teams in the corridors, because all of them are trainees from the Royal Marines School of Music, who will also be performing tonight's choir in the second half. They're going to be heavily laden down with trays containing books and DVDs and CDs, including a CD of last year's Mountbatten Festival of Music, and flags, of course. Yes. Which you will all need for our patriotic finale at the end. So at least buy a flag, 50 pence, cheap at the price. And may I ask you also to just do your bit and relieve them of all their burdens. Spend freely is what I'd like you to do. There's also a shop at kiosk at door 6 where you can buy a full range of Royal Marines band memorabilia. And if you pre-order, you'll guarantee being one of the first to own a CD of tonight's show. So please don't go home without a memento for this evening. And also, what about these fabulous souvenir programmes? They are amazing. They've got masses of information, lots of action photographs from the Royal Marines, looking wonderful, and there's even a photograph of a rather old actor in there as well. So anyway, that's the pitch, sales pitch over. Right, to conclude the first half of tonight's concert, we have music from the versatile and highly talented American singer-songwriter Billy Joel, who's had top 40 hits in four decades. For this festival, some of his best-known songs have been arranged by band color Sergeant Trevor Norton, featuring Piano Man, River of Dreams, Just the Way You Are, Longest Time, Tell Her About It, and She's Got Away. It will, of course, feature the piano with band sergeant Hannah Trudgeon, and on saxophone we will hear... Quite right. And on saxophone we will hear band color Sergeant Gordon Carter and band Corporal Andy Spain. Well, Gordon Carter has got a huge amount of people in, including his darling wife, Karen. And I'm told that what he's going to play tonight, this duet he's going to play, Just the Way You Are, was the song you first danced to at your wedding. Isn't that lovely? Yes. They're no longer talking to each other, but never mind. And these are also joined by musicians Lucy Aslett and Bronwyn Deacon. Next on trumpet, a band Corporal Mark Upton and musician Josh Tones. Good old Josh. And then band Corporal John Rushton on flugelhorn. Right, ladies and gentlemen, in his debut as a conductor at the festival and leading us to the interval with Piano Man, please give a warm welcome to the Director of Music from the Commando Training Center, Royal Marines, Captain Steve Green.
We'll be right back.
London. My name's Danny Sheen, and I'll be your backstage host for tonight's show. I'm sure you'll agree the first half was fantastic. My personal favourites were the ever fabulous core of drums and the amazing xylophone solos. What were your favourites? Tell me in the comments on the live stream below. As I'm sure you'll agree, even the best military musicians in the world deserve a break. So stay tuned for the next 20 minutes as I find some unsuspecting soloists to pounce on an interview, and I'll tell you more about the great cause that we're working towards tonight. This concert is aiming to raise as much money as possible for the Royal Marines charity, who do fantastic work for Royal Marines and their families in times of need. We'd love your support, so please donate by texting BAND 17 £5 to 770 to donate £5. Please remember though, this is only for UK viewers, so if you're watching overseas, you can still donate by visiting www.theroyalmarinescharity.org.uk/donate. And if you're watching after the show, please remember, you can still donate. Please help us to support their fantastic work. It really is a brilliant cause. Thank you.
I was a section commander with Charlie Company in 40 Commando, and we went into Iraq. So I was on the first flights, helicopters going in, and then I'd done 3 tours of Afghanistan.
It was just a normal Afghan morning, and I could just see 2 guys sat down. It just didn't fit, didn't look right. When I turned literally 1 step,
I'd just come back off Christmas leave when I was driving along the M3 and I came across an accident. So I immediately pulled over. I was making sure the people who they'd got out of the vehicle, they were okay. When another car crashed into that one and its engine and gearbox complete came flying out, travelled about 70 metres and completely took off my right leg and dislocated my left leg.
400 pieces of shrapnel in me, severed my carotid artery. I broke my neck and my leg, ended up falling off. So that's, yeah, here's what it is. Brain damage, that was, yeah, of course, brain damage. Trust me to forget the brain damage.
I wasn't prepared even for a second to admit that this might be a battle that I was going to lose. I was a colour sergeant in the Royal Marines. I define myself in very physical terms as a physically able person.
I realised I wasn't going to be a Marine anymore. I didn't take it very well at all. I rebelled against everybody.
I was a year of being a disabled person and I was struggling to come to terms with that.
Unfortunately, it's the people closest to you that get hurt the most. I took it out on my wife. You know, we get draped in medals and stuff all the time, but they get no recognition for what they put up with. And they are, yeah, the good bits of kit on their wives.
The opportunity came up to row across the Atlantic as part of the world's first physically disabled team of four to do it. A big motivation, or you know, something that kept us going the whole way across, was having our families there, and the Royal Marines charity were a massive part in making that possible.
A great opportunity I was given after being blown up was to climb Mount Kilimanjaro in Tanzania. The core charity, you know, paid for my wife to come with me up to the, you know, to the roof of Africa, you know, and to just, you know, all this crap we've been through over the last few years, and then to be stood on the roof of Africa with your best mate, you know, your wing woman, you know, was pretty special. And it was all because the charity enabled that, and they didn't have to do that, you know. She's not a Royal Marine, but she's part of the family, you know, the Royal Marines core family. And it's, I say, once you're in, you know, and it's an amazing thing to be part of.
From the old guys that served years ago through the Falklands and before, to young lads now who, you know, are piecing their lives together after active service in Afghanistan. It's something I feel really passionate about because I am a Royal Marine. I will always be a Royal Marine. And I will always feel passionate about the Royal Marines charity because that's what's there to look out for us Royal Marines.
This concert is aiming to raise as much money as possible for the Royal Marines charity, who do fantastic work for Royal Marines and their families in times of need. We'd love your support. So please donate by texting BAND 17 £5 to 770 to donate £5. Please remember though, this is only for UK viewers, so if you're watching overseas, you can still donate by visiting www.theroyalmarinescharity.org.uk/donate. And if you're watching after the show, please remember you can still donate. Ladies and gentlemen, we've already been treated to some amazing solos tonight, and I'm sure you'll recognise these two gentlemen on the couch beside me from dazzling us recently with their amazing xylophones. So could I please introduce Band Corporal Mike Smith.
Hello.
And musician Joe Kemp.
Hello.
So hello, thank you very much for joining me. So Mike, how did tonight go for you?
I went really well, actually. We've been looking forward to this. We managed to put one together last year as well, but it went down really well. Audience gave us a lot of good feedback, and the laughter helps us spur us on and probably add bits in every time we play it, so it's good.
Fantastic. Now, Joe, you're obviously performing in the Royal Albert Hall, fairly prestigious venue. Did you have any jitters, or how does it feel performing in a venue like this?
I mean, there's always jitters. It's quite a scary thing, as there's a lot of people out there, but as Mike said, you just feed off the excitement, the crowd, what they give you and stuff just helps add to the performance. And yeah, it's always scary, but normally I get to dress up like an idiot, so it helps. But
I can say that always helps.
Yeah.
So I have memories at school of sort of tinkling with the glockenspiel, never got quite as fast as you guys have managed to do. So how long does it take to learn a solo like that?
Okay, for that solo, I didn't have a lot of time to prepare for it after coming off the M1s, which is our senior command musicians training, and then my seniors. However, it's a good amount of hours, extra time after work, and just learning patterns really helps you sort of memorise it and get it to the speed you need it to be. So it's patterns, really.
Fantastic. What does, as well as a xylophone, but you're not xylophonist, you're percussionist, what does that actually mean in the Royal Marines Band Service? What else do you play?
So we have to play everything, basically. So we play xylophones, snare drums, drum kits, timpani, auxiliary percussion, everything that you can hit, we hit. You get the 3 years training package to learn all of that, but yeah, we have to specialise in basically all of it. The xylophone's a very small part of our actual what we can play, so yeah.
Fantastic. Now, percussionists always have a reputation in the band service of being, I see sort of wry smiles going on here, of being lovely, but sort of slightly mischievous characters. Do you think that is a reputation that is deserved?
I think that's fairly true. I think we're the furthest away from the conductor, so you can get away with a little bit. We're also catching the eye all the time because we're moving from instrument to instrument. Obviously, Joe said we play all of them, so we do move from instrument to instrument, which I really enjoy doing. Maybe stealing the limelight when we can. So it's good that they give us the bit at the front because it means we're probably a bit calmer at the back.
Makes sense. And how hard is it to learn the solos from memory? I know we talked about patterns and actually how you do it, but do you get ones that just don't click sometimes, or is it always the same every time?
Yeah, I mean, it's normally bits within a solo that don't click, so you can be, everyone knows the tune that we play tonight, and those bits are the easy bits, and once you've got them, you find yourself practicing the bits you can already play, which doesn't help. But then there's various bars in it that don't click, like you said, and you have to spend hours just repeating and repeating. Like I said, it's all repetition. It's all learning the patterns, yeah. And then eventually it clicks, and yeah, it all goes well, hopefully. So.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So, how many Mountbatten Festival of Musics have you done, respectively?
I've done six.
Six, fantastic. Yeah.
And I've done four.
And yeah. How does this one, or how do they sort of compare to what you do for the rest of the year? Are they special? Are they just another gig, or how does it feel?
Yeah, they are special. It's our sort of signature concert that we're aiming towards. Some of the bands don't get to do as many concerts as others, just because they've got a sort of criteria of marching side of things. So when it comes to the concert and we're all together, it's a big sound, a big wall of sound. We get to put a massive production on. It's the production team is all in-house. We do everything ourselves. And I think it just shows that we are capable of all the things that we can do, not just within music, but when we go and do the military roles as well, we can put our hands to anything because it's all us. It's all on us.
Absolutely. And how are they for you, Joe?
I can't remember the question after that.
Sorry. Oh, sorry. I told you they were mischievous.
Zoned out.
How do it wasn't that bad, please. How do Mountbatten Festival of Musics compare to what you do for the rest of the year?
Okay, yeah, I'm generally quite excited throughout the year anyway, so it is another level on top of what we do, but every day in work's exciting for me. Get to work with people like Mike and all the other guys are great, and it's just as they say, the best job in the world. It's good fun.
That's a pretty amazing thing to be able to say. Well, I won't keep you any longer because I know you've got to dash off. Thank you so much for your fantastic solos. And I'm sure we'll see you being naughty at the back of the band for the second half.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We've had great support for this charitable live stream from The Telegraph, the Royal Windsor Horse Show, the Portsmouth Historic Dockyard, and the Royal Yacht Britannia. It seems only fitting now to let you, the audience, be in chance to win some fabulous prizes that have been donated from these generous supporters for you and your family. First up, we have five pairs of tickets to visit the Royal Yacht Britannia in Edinburgh. All you need to do is answer in the comments section. Someone will then be picked at random across the streams and we'll contact them after the show. Let's find out more about the Royal Yacht Britannia in Edinburgh. Did you know there are a number of bandsmen here tonight that actually served on the Royal Yacht Britannia and sailed around the world in her? Incredible. If you want to be up for a chance to win 5 pairs of tickets to visit the Royal Yacht Britannia in Edinburgh, all you have to do is answer the question in the comments below. The question is, how many countries make up the United Kingdom? That's how many countries make up the United Kingdom. Answer in the comments section, and 5 people at random will be picked across all the streams to win tickets to the Royal Yacht Britannia up in Edinburgh. Tonight's concert, as you know, is showcasing the wonderful massed bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines. But what you might not know is that the Royal Marines Band Service is made up of 5 individual professional military bands. They are considered the best military marching band in the world. And their job includes performing at national ceremonial duties and for royalty, as we're seeing tonight, as well as travelling throughout the UK and the globe, representing the Royal Marines and the Royal Navy. Over the past 2 years alone, Royal Marine musicians and buglers have travelled to countries including Australia, New Zealand, India, Chile, Beirut, France, Germany, Singapore, Malta, Oman, Switzerland, the United States of America, Nepal, and Hawaii. Here's a quick glimpse of what they've been up to.
Good morning from Sweden.
Now, if you or someone you know would be interested in becoming one of these brilliant musicians on stage and joining the Royal Marines Band Service, then please visit the Royal Navy's recruitment website for more details. You can also visit the band's Facebook page at the Bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines Official. This concert is aiming to raise as much money as possible for the Royal Marines charity, who do fantastic work for Royal Marines and their families in times of need. We'd love your support, so please donate by texting BAND 17 £5 to 770 to donate £5. Please remember though, this is only for UK viewers, so if you're watching overseas, you can still donate by visiting www.fundraising.org. therawmarinescharity.org.uk/donate. And if you're watching after the show, please remember you can still donate. Please help us to support their fantastic work. It really is a brilliant cause. Thank you. Now, we had the first competition earlier, and I think it's about time we had another one. Up for grabs now are 5 family tickets to the historic dockyard in Portsmouth, worth a whopping £75 each. Let's see what you can get up to there. If you'd like to be in for a chance to win one of 5 family tickets to the historic dockyard in Portsmouth, then all you have to do is answer the question in the comments section below. Someone will be picked at random across all live streams, and they'll receive a message soon after the show. So, for a family ticket to the historic dockyard in Portsmouth, answer the following question. What is the name of the famous river running through London? That's what is the name of the famous river running through London? Answer in the comments section and 5 people will be picked at random to win a family ticket to the historic dockyard in Portsmouth. Good luck. Now, the Royal Marines Band Service covers all musical engagements for the Royal Marines and the Royal Navy. Let's see what those 2 services have been up to. We'll be right back.
Let's have a round of applause for Stephen Green, the musical director. Fantastic. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Welcome back. Suitably refreshed, I trust, and also laden down with all you've bought at the various areas this evening, I'm sure. Now, we open the second half with a rock classic, Another Brick in the Wall, first featured nearly 40 years ago in Pink Floyd's rock opera, The Wall. This spectacular arrangement by Colour Sergeant Phil Trudgeon was the winning entry. Yes, Phil Trudgeon, jolly good. Yeah. Cheer whenever the hell you like, it'd be wonderful. He was the winning entry in the 2016 Royal Marines Band Service competition for musical compositions and arrangements. But now, come on, let's give a really good round of applause for that brilliant guitar soloist, Band Sergeant Andy Pratt. And like me, he's from Portsmouth. Yes. Now, we have a really unique treat for you. It's very rare to have guest artists at the Mountbatten Festival of Music. Top secret drum corps from Switzerland first came to notice in this country when they performed at the 2003 Royal Edinburgh Military Tattoo. With their leader, Eric Julliard, their members include bankers, civil servants, and factory workers who give up their free time to practice nearly every day. Since that 2003 performance in Edinburgh, they have enjoyed worldwide success. And in May 2016, the Drum Corps were invited to take part in the spectacular 90th birthday celebration for Her Majesty the Queen at Windsor. Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Switzerland, and for the very first time at the Royal Albert Hall, please welcome the elite Top Secret Drum Corps. Wow, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa. Don't. It sounds as though you're clapping me. Don't clap me. Let's just hear it again for those amazing drummers. If only I could bring them on again. I can't. Yes. Absolutely sensational. Sensational. Swiss watches always been renowned for their timing, and now we know why. My God. Absolutely fantastic. Do you know, I cannot believe I'm as lucky to stand here and do this job. I mean, I'm so in awe of these people who have job, their work, they work on the front line, they've been to Afghanistan, they're all talented sportsmen, and they're brilliant musicians, all of them. Yeah. Makes me feel rather humble, I have to say, rather poor little actor. Anyway, now, continuing the international theme. Took a bit of time to get over there, that bit. 2016 again saw Royal Marines bands travelling extensively to support UK diplomatic and defence engagement to far-flung locations such as Dubai, Abu Dhabi, New Zealand, Washington DC, Sweden and Switzerland, to name just a few. Great opportunities for promoting global Britain with the best of British. I think you'd agree, ladies and gentlemen. Well, today, yeah. Today, the band service continues to recruit. So if you know anyone who may be interested in a fantastic and varied career in music, especially in to fill our categories of vocalist and guitar, please direct them to our Facebook page, the details of which are on the screens. Ah. If only I was a few years younger. Ladies and gentlemen, our next piece was originally composed for full symphony orchestra by the American composer John Adams in 1986. Written in the composer's post-minimal style, it's an exciting and energetic piece. Explaining the title, A Short Ride in a Fast Machine, the composer said, "You know when someone asked you to ride in a terrific sports car, and then you wished you hadn't? Well, it certainly provides a great workout for the band and conductor. The percussion section in particular is pivotal to the performance, especially whoever picks up the woodblock." There he is. Probably got thousands of family in tonight just to hear him go crash, crash. Yay, wonderful, wonderful. Returning to conduct this, and he's here already, and the remainder of tonight's program, please fasten your seatbelts and welcome back, of course, the Principal Director of Music, Royal Marines, Lieutenant Colonel Nick Grace, OBE. Thank you. Wow, that was a pretty fast musical ride there. And what did you think of that? Well done, the mass bands, and of course, that important woodblock. Well, each year, Colonel Nick and his team aim to put together as musically diverse programme as possible, covering a wide selection of musical genre. This year, it was decided to include music from ever-popular West End and Broadway musicals. Fresh from completing his bandmaster's course only last year, Band Sergeant Nick West has arranged some well-known songs from popular musicals of the last decade, including music from Chicago, Blood Brothers, Chorus Line, Hairspray, in a piece entitled All That Jazz. Now, this will feature musicians Sam McIndoe and George... Yes, they said they were drinkers, her family. And George Gissing on vocals. You obviously met. Band Corporal Matt Bowditch on trombone and Band Corporal Mark Upton on trumpet, along with our very own Dixie Band and our CD sellers will now perform as the Royal Marines School of Music Choir. Plus, watch out for that little something extra as well. Ladies and gentlemen, recreating the smell of the grease paint and hopefully the roar of the crowd, please enjoy our medley of musicals, All That Jazz.
tell me it's not true. Say it's just a story, something on the news. Tell me it's not true. From an old movie of Marilyn Monroe.
the hands of time, but you know it just can't be.
And if they try to stop us, here we, I'll call the end of a racing me.
Saw the light, a man and a woman like to shake it on a Saturday night. And so I'm gonna shake and shimmy it with all of my might today. Cause you pissed off the motion of the ocean or the rain from above. They can try to stop the paradise we're dreaming of, but they cannot stop the rhythm of to us in love. Stop my happiness, cause I like the way I am. And you just can't stop my knife and fork when I see a Christmas ham. And if you don't like the way I look, well, I just don't give a damn. Cause the world keeps spinning round and round, and my heart's keeping time to the speed of sound. I was lost till I heard the drums, and I found my way. Ever since this whole world began, a woman thought I'd let you shake it, shake it, shake up a man. And so I'm gonna shake and shimmy it the best that I can today. Cause you can't stop the motion of the ocean, of the sun and the sky. You can wonder if you wanna, but I never ask why. And if you try to hold me down, I'm gonna spit in your eye and say,
you can't stop the beat.
and I come on to silence. Wasn't that? No, come on, that was amazing, wasn't it? And I'm standing there, and your singing tonight was out of this world. It was brilliant. And I think you should give yourselves a round of applause. You've been a wonderful audience. Yeah, come on, yeah. And what about these guys? We've just got to give them another round of applause. And you did. Yes. You did. And what's more, you rightly gave them a standing ovation. And those that couldn't stand just couldn't. We all get to that stage sometimes. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of us all, may I thank you so much in supporting this year's festival and for your generosity, helping us raise much needed funds for our charities. Now, do keep in touch with the bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines via Twitter and on our Facebook page. We will be back here again next year, a little earlier, on the 8th, 9th, and 10th of March for the 2018 Mountbatten Festival of Music. As you leave the hall a little later, you will see our Royal Marines charity bucket collectors. They're all a year older now. So will you please spare a thought for them as you offer your donations? Because those buckets can get very heavy with coins. And most of them collecting can remember life before decimal coinage. So please, notes are the preferred medium. We finish the concert tonight in traditional style, with the march past of the Royal Navy, Heart of Oak, the march past of the Royal Marine Commandos, Sarry Marais, and of course conclude with the regimental march of Her Majesty's Royal Marines, A Life on the Ocean Wave. And all those serving and former serving are encouraged to stand for their march. And now another Mountbatten Festival tradition has become the chance of a little something extra at the end, as long as you make your appreciation known properly, which I'm sure you will. Now, as I said at the start, this year's festival is the last for Nick Grace. And before you applaud, it would just be nice if I could give you a few facts about this remarkable man. For 35 years, he's been a military musician. And for the last 8 years, he's been Principal Director of Music Royal Marines and the director of this wonderful festival. Ladies and gentlemen, in 2009, Nick Grace was clapped in. And now, 8 years later, gotta say it, clapped out. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to raise the roof for this wonderful man. It's his last appearance here. I want you to give him a round of applause that he will remember for the rest of his lifetime. So, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Lieutenant Colonel Nick Grace, OBE. So on behalf of Nick and his fellow directors of music and the bass bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines, may I, Charles Collingwood, wish you all a very good night and a safe journey home. Good night.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the show has sadly come to an end, but weren't the Royal Marines absolutely fantastic? My personal favourite was that incredible West End medley halfway through the second half. What was yours? Tell me in the comments below, hit the like button, and you can even tweet us with the hashtag MFMLive. Now, of course, tonight's concert is in aid of the Royal Marines charity, who do incredible work for Royal Marines and their families in times of need. We'd really love your support, so please donate by texting BAND 17 £5 to 770 to donate £5. And of course, remember, this is only for UK viewers, but if you're overseas, you can always donate by visiting www.theroyalmarinescharity.org.uk/donate. And you can still donate after the show has ended. Thanks so much for your support. Now, the man next to me you may recognise as he wields the main baton in front of the massed bands, it is none other than Lieutenant Colonel Nick Grace, OBE, the Principal Director of Music, Royal Marines, and the boss of every musician performing here tonight. So, Nick, thank you very much for joining me.
An absolute pleasure.
It was a fantastic show. How do you think it went for you?
It went really well. I was very, very pleased how the band played. They've been playing great all week. But with the audience who thoroughly enjoyed it, and you can tell by the feedback and reaction you get from the audience, it was brilliant, and it doesn't get any better than that.
Fantastic. So you've played some really beautiful pieces of music tonight, some more upbeat, some more mellow. Is there, dare I say, a particular favourite?
I think my personal favourite is perhaps the quietest piece that we play, which is the oboe solo, La Califa. Beautifully orchestrated and arranged, but then delivered, the oboe solo delivered by band colour sergeant Joe Sharp. It is just sublime, and I don't think it gets any better than that. But then the rest of the show equally as good and exciting and emotional as well at times, but thoroughly enjoyable.
I think the success of the Mountbatten Festival of Music is that it does always have that mix of music, so you're not getting too sad, too happy, you know. It's I think that's a key ingredient to success.
Absolutely. I totally agree. And we try and take the audience on a journey, and I think hopefully they feel they've gone on that journey from, you know, the opening, the marches with the choral drums, classical overtures, beautiful solos as I've spoken, but then, you know, the medleys, the music from the shows, and obviously those special drummers. It's phenomenal.
World famous corps of drums, of course. I've already been talking about them quite a bit tonight.
Yes.
So I've heard that this is actually your last Mountbatten Festival of Music. You're going to be going on to retire later this year. Well-deserved retirement. So I was wondering if you had any highlights of your career. I know that's quite a hard question because you've had a fairly long and illustrious career, but let me
well, it depends how long we've got, really. well, tonight was a highlight. Absolute highlight, you know, to end my career, you know, later on this year, but with my final Mountbatten Festival of Music. It doesn't get any better than that, as I said before, but, you know, conducting the mass bands, anytime I conduct our bands, it's a huge honour and privilege. And for me, it's really humbling to go out there and, you know, be in front of them and ask them to perform. And they always, you know, perform to the highest standard. They commit everything. You know, they work really hard in practicing, rehearsing, and they just want to make the best performance every time and improve, keep improving. So for me, the highlight of my career have been the people that I've been working with.
That's a really lovely answer. So we are raising money tonight for the Royal Marines charity. Is there anything you'd like to say to those that are viewing at home to encourage them to donate to this worthy cause?
Yeah, I've been on operational duty and seen the effects of war on people and combat, conflict. And not just that, it's the families that are affected, directly affected by it. And the Royal Marines charity looks after those families, and they do need a lot of help. Obviously, the obvious guys who need limbs, but then there's the post-traumatic stress elements that they're looking after, then the families as well, and also people who are currently serving that they're helping out, who might be on hard times or need assistance any which way they can. And I think for the service that our Royal Marines have given this country, and some the ultimate sacrifice, I think it's only right, you know, we can play all the music and put people in a good mood. And if everybody's enjoyed tonight, please do text the number and donate to the charity. It's well worth it, and it will be, and it is really, really appreciated.
Thank you very much. Well, thank you again for joining me. It's been really interesting, and congratulations on a really fantastic show.
Thanks very much.
Thanks.
I was a section commander with Charlie Company in 40 Commando, and we went into Iraq. So I was on the first flights, helicopters going in, and then I'd done 3 tours of Afghanistan.
It was just a normal Afghan morning, and I could just see 2 guys sat down. It just didn't fit, didn't look right. When I turned literally 1 step,
I'd just come back off Christmas leave when I was driving along the M3, and I came across an accident. So obviously I immediately pulled over. I was making sure the people who they'd got out of the vehicle, they were okay. When another car crashed into that one, and its engine and gearbox complete came flying out, travelled about 70 metres, and completely took off my right leg, and dislocated my left leg.
400 pieces of shrapnel in me, 7 my carotid artery. I broke my neck and my leg, ended up falling off. So that's, yeah, is what it is. Brain damage, of course, brain damage. Trust me to forget the brain damage.
I wasn't prepared even for a second to admit that this might be a battle that I was going to lose. As a colour sergeant in the Royal Marines, I define myself in very physical terms as a physically able person.
I realised I wasn't going to be a Marine anymore. I didn't take it very well at all. I rebelled against everybody.
I was a year of being a disabled person, and I was struggling to come to terms with that.
Unfortunately, it's the people closest to you that get hurt the most, and I took it out on my wife. You know, we get draped in medals and stuff all the time, but they get no recognition for what they put up with. And they are the good bits of kit on their wives.
The opportunity came up to row across the Atlantic as part of the world's first physically disabled team of 4 to do it. A big motivation, or, you know, something that kept us going the whole way across, was having our families there, and the Royal Marines charity were a massive part in making that possible.
A great opportunity I was given after being blown up was to climb Mount Kilimanjaro in Tanzania. The core charity, you know, paid for my wife to come with me up to the, you know, to the roof of Africa. You know, and to just, you know, all this crap we've been through the last few years, and then to be stood on the roof of Africa with your best mate, you know, your wing woman, you know, was pretty special. And it was all because the charity enabled that. And they didn't have to do that, you know. She's not a Royal Marine, but she's part of the family, you know, the Royal Marines core family. And it's, I say, once you're in, you know, and it's an amazing thing to be part of.
From the old guys that served years ago through the Falklands and before, to young lads now who, you know, were piecing their lives together after active service in Afghanistan. It's something I feel really passionate about, because I am a Royal Marine, I will always be a Royal Marine, and I will always feel passionate about the Royal Marines charity, because that's what's there to look out for us Royal Marines.
We are now at the end of the evening, and what an incredible show it has been. We've seen the massed bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines, the world-famous Corps of Drums, the Fanfare Team, the top-secret drum corps from Switzerland, and some amazing soloists, all of which have dazzled us with their talents tonight. If you enjoyed it, then please write a comment below and also hit that like button. But perhaps even more importantly, if you've enjoyed it and think that you have some friends that would enjoy it too, then please share so we can spread the concert even further. We're raising money today for the Royal Marines charity, who do much needed and incredible work for Royal Marines and their families in times of need. We'd love your support. So to donate, if you're a UK viewer, please just text BAND 17 £5 to 770 to donate £5. And if you're overseas, you can donate by visiting www.theroyalmarinescharity.org.uk/donate. And remember, you can still donate even after the concert has finished. Thank you so much for all your support. If you'd like to purchase a DVD or audio CD of this show, then they'll be released soon. All you need to do is visit the Bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines official Facebook page, hit the like button, and you'll be informed when they're ready. We'd once again like to thank The Telegraph, the Royal Windsor Horse Show, the Portsmouth Historic Dockyard, and the Royal Yacht Britannia for supporting this live stream. My name is Danny Sheen, and I've been your backstage host for tonight's show. Thank you so much for watching and for supporting the Royal Marines charity. If you'd like to find out more about what the charity does, and indeed to donate, then please just visit www.theroyalmarinescharity.org.uk. Thanks again for watching, and good night.